Did you know you can re-insulate your exterior walls without removing your drywall? I'll tell you how in 4 easy steps. Let's talk about it. If you've come across this video, you're probably doing research to help with problems like high energy bills, drafty walls, or hot or cold rooms in the house, something like that that's causing discomfort or wasting money on energy costs. And you're probably seeing that insulating or re-insulating is the recommended choice. However, maybe you don't want to completely gut the inside of your house to have something like spray foam installed that requires an open cavity. You are in luck because I'm going to explain how RetroFoam injection foam can completely re-insulate those exterior walls without you having to tear the inside down. These are 4 easy steps that are going to explain how we can re-insulate your exterior walls without the mess and the fuss of a total remodel. Step 1, we need to address the exterior of the home. Now, whether your house has siding, which is most common, or brick or block, or even something like slate siding or wood siding, yes, your house can be re-insulated with RetroFoam. Let's just say, for example, if you have a clad siding like aluminum or vinyl. What the crew will do is we will take a strip of siding off around the exterior of the house, and this will expose that exterior cavity. Step 2, the crew will now drill a hole into every single stud cavity around the entire perimeter of the house. This gives us access again to every single cavity to make sure that we can insulate the entire perimeter of the home. This is key to make sure that we are helping to establish that building envelope. Step 3 is where the magic happens. This is where we will come in and actually inject the RetroFoam into all of those stud cavities. Now again, this foam is specifically designed to be injected into an enclosed cavity. What happens is the foam is put in through a hose, which is placed all the way down and all the way to the top of your stud cavity. The foam is then injected and fills all the nooks and crannies of that wall cavity. Something that we lose track of is that, again, we build houses with wood. This creates a lot of joints and a lot of cracks and crevices that can lead to air infiltration. That's why foam works so well to fill in those cracks to stop that air from coming into or out of your home when you don't want it to. So again, this step is concluded when all the cavities around your home are completely filled up with RetroFoam insulation. If you've already gotten useful information out of this video, do us a favor, like this video, but go down and also subscribe to our channel and ring that bell so you get all of our notifications. Step 4 is us putting everything back together. First of all, we're going to want to clean up any foam that may have fallen on the ground or siding during this process. Of course, we're going to plug that hole that we had to drill and then put the siding back on. And lastly, we're going to do a cleaning of everything before we leave. Our goal is always to leave the house in the same condition to where you, even the homeowner, cannot tell that we were there and did any work by the time that we're done. Now, I do want to say if you have a brick house or a block house or wood or something different, yes, the process will be very, very similar. Just some of the steps may be a little bit different. Don't worry, we can definitely go into detail for your specific house. If you found this information useful and you think this could be a good option for you and your home, you should check out our description below. Go to our Find a Dealer page where you can find the closest RetroFoam dealer near you, and again, they can go into detail on how they would insulate your exact home. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.